Hello and welcome to the final video in my Porsche series. Here we're looking at all the 911 castings that I have. There may be one or two I've missed out and haven't found in my box. Like, I'm sure I got a couple more colours of this
variant here.
And possibly of this one.
This casting of the 911 there.
Some of these, there's only one or two versions, and like this Matchbox has been around forever and there are so many colours. Well, we'll start off in this corner with the 911 GT3 RS. Hot wheels been made for a long time and various generations.
Including the latest release that came out very recently.
I've just added to the collection the last couple of weeks to the
oldest versions, which they're
still making. Variants like this, I think it was in a 5-pack a couple of years ago. Luckily these three are all in pretty good condition. I've either found them new or unmolested, but...
and destroyed, but they... quite often you find these...
pretty damaged. I've got the red version, missing a spoiler, lots of scratched glass and stuff.
But I managed to get three here that are pretty factory fresh.
They did the headlights
as part of the windscreen, so you get that design and lots of side tempo work.
Well, you don't get anything on the back. That's just plain, which is a shame. They've done it on later versions, this latest
generation has it. Good to see a full tempoed version.
Now this red one here is the only variant I got of that one. And this is... the GT2 911. It's the only one I got. It's got a few marks on it. Be nice to get a few more to fill that casting out. As you can see to the right, I've got a lot of this version, and as probably seen with other YouTube videos,
they produced a lot of this casting in various colours.
You look down the. All sorts of colours, tempo designs, some recent releases like the Forza, and this one was in a multi 5-pack. These few on the end here
are new, really good condition. This is the Forza, although
we've got a couple here that are pretty rubbed up. But pick up any that are in, licensed in supercars. This orange one here, I'd love to get a mint version of that colour, just pops particularly under these lights. Quite often come with the
side tempos, as
you can see. And most of them,
they
have it. The back design's quite good, but again, no tail lights. Apart from the orange one, which doesn't have the side tempos, so you manage to get that. Matte paint on the Forza. There's the gloss. Good to get a few more
versions of this one.
And in the corner, a more recent casting. Favourites of the purple version. I love the wheels on it. I love the shade of purple. Suits the car and it stands out amongst the other 911s for me. Even though the two other variants I got are arguably more scream and shout, being yellow from the. Here's the factory 500 set. It's quite a popular one. I've got this one. It's got a few, so I've got a couple of boxes, and then one opened up, and then this with all the crazy tempo work and that black paint. From a couple of years ago. Feels so recent, but it's
probably been a couple of years since this one came out.
And then bang up to date a couple of months ago.
This one was available and I think I picked it up sometime in July.
So it's got headlights, part
of the windscreen, all the grills, the badges, rear
plates and lights.
Definitely finish this one off.
With black wheels. I think overall it's probably the best casting, and it should be, as it's the most modern, with modern building techniques. And having those lights on the back really do add to it. close second would be the previous generation.
Now looking to the right, you have some slightly older 90s and 80s and versions. This one's part of the Forza set. The big wing on the back and the body kit. Released in various colours.
This is the only one I've managed to find so far in my collection.
Looks good in blue. Was easily available a couple
of years ago, particularly in Sainsbury's.
Could pick them up. As many as you wanted, fill your boots with them. And then the same generation 911, Hot Wheels brought out this, which I think Hot Wheels did a very good job of. They managed to tempo the headlights on all but the white one, but then they decided to tempo everything else.
Got the badges, the engine covers.
You got the shape correct. And the choices of wheels are nice and in keeping with the car.
Probably favourite's the yellow one
in that pearl paint. It sort of pops.
Oh, I wouldn't mind seeing the white version.
With possibly the wheels from the black one on it, without the tempo design, a plain white. Really smart, and hopefully this will be a candidate for a premium car culture version in the near future.
We haven't had a version,
a colour variant in a while, so hopefully we'll get another one soon to add to the set.
Now a very old casting
of this Matchbox. Latest releases in
white and this green.
Still holds its own,
sat next to these more modern castings.
Even though it's 25 years old now. I think overall the white version's my favourite. Although those gold wheels on the green are very smart. They might look good on the Hot Wheels ones over there.
Be a good version to add, and of course there's only two of these.
As we know, this one's just like this casting here. There are so many colour variants.
I remember having a dark red maroon one as a kid.
And I was playing with that 20 years ago.
Now next door, last minute find I found in the box, the rally version of 911. I've had for a couple of years. It came out, I think,
pre-COVID.
The equipment on the back, the spare tyre and jerry pan, all the timber work down the side and the winch.
And next door is one I picked up this
morning because I knew I was doing the Porsche video, and Pound Stretch had a case of Matchbox that we didn't get in
Tesco. Now they had sold out of a lot,
but I had one of these Porsches left.
What's been open, but the car was inside and
still sealed in its plastic,
so it's all good. So I managed to produce two cars there for us to look at.
And at the back, the moving parts 911.
This one you can open
the door. Came out a couple of years ago. Got mine at the Entertainer. Can resist it. It's very in keeping with a lot of the cars of the area. This is the 911 of the 80s we think of, with
the big wing on the back, the whale tail, the red paint, dark wheels, tan interior. It's a definitely a good homage to it, and it'll be very good to see what a company like Mini GT or one of the other premium manufacturers could do in this era.
Porsche 911.
In these colours, fully stocked.
Road going version. The one I'll be eager to add to the collection.
So I hope you enjoyed the video series.
It's the final one. Of course, I'll be adding
Porsches to my collection all the time. There's so many that come out.
If you got any more suggestions for video series, please let me know. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.